I'm Jade, I'm 23.
And I'm Sadie, and I'm 38. I'm Jade's auntie. We've always been quite close, to be honest. But then what we kind of went through, it was just nice to have someone to talk to about it.
People who haven't had cancer don't really understand properly. So to see her being so brave and so strong as well really helped me be like, you know what? She can fight this, so can I.
Today, God?
Well, today is huge. I'm meeting an aunt and a niece who are incredible but despise their bodies. Both of them have been through severe, life-changing illnesses as well. They need to realise that their bodies are incredible. They have one and four terrible illnesses. They are both living heroes and they can't see that yet.
I'm so nervous.
I know, I'm really nervous as well, actually.
It's fine, we've got this. Yep. We're here together, so it's fine. Yep.
I think me and Sadie doing this journey together will just help us both come out the other side after everything that's happened to us in the last year. Sadie was diagnosed in the June, I believe, and then it was middle of September that I found out I had cancer. I feel the cancer changed who I am as a person. I don't feel like I'm the same Jade I was a year ago. So I need to learn to love my new shape and not be constantly looking back at the Jade I was.
To help Jade accept her body, the first hurdle is for her to stand in front of the mirrors and really look and see her curves for what they are.
How are you, Jade?
Well, nice to meet you.
Oh, nice. Sorry, nearly on the lips. And we've only just met. How are you?
Yeah, nervous.
Nervous about what?
The mirrors. I don't do mirrors.
So, Jade, tell me everything that I need to know.
I'm 23. I live with my parents near Brighton. Went to uni, studied drama, which is kind of my passion, but I'm just a quiet person.
So tell me then how the quiet drama student at the age of 23 ended up here today with me.
Well, I had lymphoma last year. So I had 4 months of inpatient intensive treatment. So I lost all my hair. It was really scary because I wasn't sure if I was gonna make Christmas or, sorry.
It's okay.
I didn't want to die and I was really scared that I wasn't gonna get better. I feel like no matter how many times they tell me that I'm in remission and I'm okay, it will always be in the back of my mind and I don't think it will ever go away.
I can see how difficult this is for you to do. Yeah. But tell me about your body.
I hate my stomach.
Okay.
I feel repulsed. When my boyfriend touches it, it makes me kind of flinch and I just want him to get his hands away. It was hard because that's where the doctors would have to poke and prod.
And post-cancer, how do you feel about the rest of your body?
I hate it all, especially my hair, because that was always the kind of last thing I would do to finish off a look. And I can't do anything with my hair now. So I feel, what's the point in wearing a nice dress if I look so awful?
I think that we should get you unchanged.
Okay.
Because I think we have to have a really good look.
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
I don't like looking at myself. I don't think it looks nice. My stomach's too big and I've got flabby thighs. I just look disgusting. No one could ever love someone who looked as disgusting as this.
You know, it's such a complex situation, Jade. And I can stand here for an hour telling you all the reasons why your body is beautiful, but I'm not gonna bother because you're not gonna listen to me. Mm. Yet. Because I'm going to convince you 100% that you are beautiful and you deserve to have people that like you. How does that feel?
Yeah, it feels good.
Our relationships with our bodies aren't as easy as ABC, and Jade is evidence of that. She's a very young woman that's gone through a very adult trauma with her health. and I can't move on any further until she realises that all bodies are beautiful, regardless of their age, shape or size. And Jade and Sadie will never be able to accept their reflection until they get up close and personal with real women with real bodies.
So before I get Sadie in front of the mirror, I'm getting them both together for a female empowerment session.
I have this theory, and that theory is that women just don't look at each other enough. You don't give each other enough compliments, you don't tell each other enough you are beautiful, and I think that all of that should change. So, we're gonna do some of that right now, but with the help of my girls. Are you ready to meet them?
Yep.
Come on in, girls! Look at their gorgeous bodies. Aren't they beautiful? What do we like when we look at our gorgeous girls?
Boobs.
Boobs! We've got so many boobs on display. Are you a boob girl?
Only because I haven't got any.
Now, they've all got very different shaped bodies. Do you not think? We've got gorgeous shoulders, got great bums. Are you feeling slightly like you want to touch their bodies by any chance?
No.
Why not? Are you kidding me? I've got a lineup of ladies that want girls. Do you want them to touch you?
Yes.
Do you want them to get in? Girls, you get in right now. Jade hates this. Come on. Why don't you just touch this part first, Jade? Just here. Jade, That was like the most awkward first date in the entire world. Can I touch the hem of your nightie? Can you have another little go? So why don't you have a little? Just have a little feel of the skin. What do we think? Isn't that gorgeous?
You're very soft.
Isn't that beautiful? Right, now, Sadie, why don't we come down? Why don't we try a tummy? Come try a tummy. What do you think
it's
there?
It's very warm. It's very nice.
It's very warm. Do you know what? You girls just don't know how to do it, right? I'm going to show you
really
how
don't.
To do it. Right, who wants it?
Ready.
Coming in, right. So if you're going to feel a tummy, you've got to feel a tummy. So you've got to, you've got to get the width of the tummy. You've got to get in, you've got to feel the heat of the tummy. Isn't that amazing? Are you offended?
Not at all.
Does that feel nice?
Yeah, great.
And do you know what? I think it feels absolutely beautiful. So get in and have a proper feel of our girls' bodies. Come on.
Anywhere? Anywhere?
It's nice touching something that I know everyone has got clearly. And I should be able to touch my own tummy and think, actually, it feels all right.
There are two girls here that are very similar to you two. So do you want to step forward, girls? So I'd like to introduce you to Sue and Angelica.
I was 17 when I was first diagnosed, and I've had cancer for 23 years, and this is my first year of remission.
And what about you, Sue?
Mine was diagnosed really early, and because it was diagnosed early, I had a lumpectomy, and I was cleared. It's the best thing to do.
And how do you feel about your body now, Sue?
Fine.
Because your body will always have had cancer.
Yeah, but I'm here, aren't I?
I know where you've been. You really have got to love yourself, because do you know what? You're strong. You've gone through what you've gone through, and you're still here. Forget what anybody else says or thinks. What you've gone through and what I've gone through and what Sue's gone through, nothing else matters, because you're still here and you're living it. And every scar, everything about you is your story, and it's a strong, beautiful story.
This is it. Our two special ladies here, what they're trying to tell you is, actually, do you know what? Your bodies are amazing.
It's just so
I want
nice
to give her a hug.
Go on, then.
No.
In fact, girls, get in.
Oh, no, having a hug.
I mean, this is the most important thing, because if women have a sense of community, if women feel that they can talk to one another about how they feel about their bodies are incredible. And actually, post-cancer, they're far more incredible because they are now superhuman.